Hello everyone, as we already discussed about the definition of percentage and how to convert the percentage into fraction and fraction into percentage, today we will discuss about the basic questions on percentage. Now, the first question is that what is 10% of 5? 50. What is 10% of 50 can be the first question. The second question is, find a number whose 10% is 5. This is the second question we can talk about. The third question can be, what percent of 50 is 5? Now these three questions are different. But when we talk about the basic questions of percentages, the concept behind all the three questions is the same. Now we look at the concept. We have to define in our mind that a basic format of any question which is in the percentage is A percent of B is equal to C, where A is one value, B is another value, and C is the third value. Once we talk about A percent of B is equal to C, this can be written as A upon 100, because percent we already know is out of 100. So per means divided by and cent means 100. So A percent can be written as A upon 100. Of means multiplication. This is the part of bond mass. B is equal to C. So the basic formula comes out to be that A upon 100 multiplied by B is equal to C. Now the question arises that out of A, B and C, either the A and B value is given to you and C we have to find out, or A and C value is given to you, B we have to find out, or B and C value is given to you and we have to find out the value of A. Now in every basic question of percentage, this will be the format where any of the two values are given and the third value we have to find out. As we have already said that A percent of B is equal to C, it means anything where B is given, before B there must be a value of, there must be a term of. So in the first question, here it is of 50. We know the value of B is 50 here. So we can say in this question, the value of A is 10%, because percentage is always given as A. The value of B is 50, because after B of there is a term B, and the value of C we have to find out, because I already discussed that two of the values are given and third value we have to find out. In this question, we look at this. This is already 10%, and we know that the percentage term is given for 10. So A is equal to 10% in this question. Now, once we are talking about is 5, so before 5 there is a term is. So this cannot be the value of B. Or when we talk about this, it is the meaning of is, or is equal to. When I am saying is equal to C, so this is C, so here the value of C is given to be 5, and definitely the third value, that is B, we have to calculate. Once we discuss about this question, here already what percent we have to analyze, so the value of A has to be identified to be find out. Of 50, so before 50 there is a term of, so this is the value of B, it comes out to be 50, and the value of C is 5. So we can say here A 10%, B is 50, C we have to find out. Like in the first case, here A and B we have to find out why A and C are given. This is the second question or the second case. While in the third case, we have to find out the value of A and B and C are given. This is the case, the third. Now, if we look at the solutions to these questions, here I can write A upon 100, as I already told, A percent of B is equal to C, into 50 is equal to C. And the value of C we have to find out, the value of A is already given to be 10%. So 10 upon 100 into 50 is C. When we cancel it out, C comes out to be 5. So here the correct answer is 5. Once we look at this question again, A percent of B is equal to C, so 10 upon 100, because it is A percent of B we have to find out, to multiply by B, because this is the unknown variable, is equals to the value of C, that is 5. And once we calculate it, so B will come 5 into 100 upon 10, and the value of B will come out to be 50. So here the correct answer comes out to be 50. Now in the third question, we have to find out the value of A. So we are saying A upon 100, because A is already given in percentage, multiply by B, that is 50, is equals to 5. Once we calculate it, it comes out to be A is equals to 5 into 2, and that is 10%. So value of A comes out to be 10%. If in case we closely see all the three examples, then A is 10%, B is 50, and C is 5. A is 10%, B is 50, and C is 5. A is 10%, B is 50, and C is 5. So we can say that conceptually, all the three are the same question. But there's a difference in the wordings, and how and what we have to find out, this we can closely analyze by putting this in mind, that A percent of B is always equal to C, where A is always given in percentage. Whatever is B, before that there must be a value of, and before C there must be a value is.